Hi guys, just printing another, well, we'll call it a cartoon character. You really can't tell what it is because it's got so much support structure around it. It's completely hiding what it looks like inside. And I am very concerned that when I try and remove the support structure, it may well break what it's trying to support. Because I've had that problem in the past. The support structure is actually stronger than the item it's supporting. Anyway, I'm doing one of my time-lapse videos on this one, so I don't want to get in the way. Just see if we can get any closer. No, I don't think you can tell what that is. It's got very thin arms. Yeah, I think I might do a little video of trying to get the support layers off it and see if we're successful. Nearly finished. Percent. Might be able to recognise it now. Might. So we wait for those last few seconds. It. Can you tell what it is yet? Because if you read the title of the video, you probably know. Well, I'll let him cool down a bit and then he should lift off there with no trouble whatsoever. Well, it's still not fully cooled down, but let's see. That's loose. Is it going to come loose? Not yet. Don't rush it, Grandad. I just really, really want to see if I can get these build layers off. Build support layers off. Without breaking the arm, because that's such a thin arm. Like I said, the support layers are thicker than the item they're supporting. Still holding on. There we go. Right. I think I might go and sit downstairs and have a go at this. Be as careful as I can. Right. Can we get the support layers off? I am very, very worried about doing this. His arms are very thin. And his neck is very thin in there as well. And a lot of these support layers are thicker than the things they're supporting. I've just got this vision of I remove one piece and his head falls off. Remove another piece and his arm snaps in the middle. really don't know where to start. The guy who designed it put warnings in the write-up on Thingiverse, warning about making it smaller, because if you reduce it in size, then those will be even smaller. Let's just try and lock off the focus for a minute first. Because I keep forgetting to do that, and the screen goes in and out while we're, or while I'm waffling. Let's see if we can get a little bit off at this end. It's all interlinked. The only good thing about it is if it all goes horribly wrong, you can all laugh at me. Can't even jam a knife in there because his arm goes under there. Right, that bit's free. That bit's free, but I'm worried about where it goes through his arm. It's come off okay. If I put too much pressure on it, I might snap his neck. You can't jam a screwdriver in there and lever it. Not hard anyway, because you'll damage the surface. Might be able to just put it in a little bit. It's even in his mouth. Looks like that's free around there. But then it comes across the front. Okay, that's good. This is all fill. That's his feet. So all that in the middle is fill. Fill support.
Okay, that's come out. I am so concerned about this. There's a piece just gripping right next to his neck, and if I push down, I'm gonna. When it's printed, all the layers are going across here. So the weakest point is his neck, just there. That is so thin. There's no strength there whatsoever. Well, I'll either cut through him or cut through my finger now. Flexing right on his neck when I'm moving that. I wonder if I cut straight across there with a pair of pliers, whether that will reduce some of the stress. I keep moving, sorry, I keep moving the camera, or moving, oh. Oh, beautiful. Right. You can see how thin that neck is. I'm not enjoying this. I mean, that's 6 hours of printing. I think it was 6 hours. Well, I thought this end was going to be easier. Because it goes right the way through and up the other side. I've got to try and separate it. I know my hand's in the way most of the time, but I'm sorry. It's just the way it's got to be at the moment. Oh, that's a nice piece coming out now. I expect if you're one of these people who likes peeling sunburn off, this would be your sort of thing. Right. Well, that's him. Do a little bit of rubbing down around the bottom there. There he is. Roger the Alien. My hands are almost shaking just holding it, because it's just so delicate. Well, that'll do. I'll tidy up a bit and we'll get a picture of him on the green surface. That's it. That's as far as I'm going to go. Obviously you can paint it. If you're really keen, you put it in a acetone bath or something and smooth it off a bit as well, apparently. But I won't be doing that.
Thanks for watching. There's always more information down in the video description. And if you like this video, you might like this one up here. And you might like to have a look at my channel over here, see what else I do. Thank you for watching.